I was just talking to one of my subscribers, and it made me realize there was another hidden motivation in terms of my healthy eating. For example, right here is some shredded coconut. What else have I been eating lately? A lot of antioxidants from tomatoes. The place I'm living, I don't really have a place to cook, so that's why it's all canned. But when I was a teenager and bleeding up until my bleeding into my 20s, I had a big fear that I would run out of time to date girls my age. I would turn 30, 40, 50, and never be able to date a teenager again. And that was a big fear of mine. You have to understand, I didn't go on my first date until I was old enough to drink. And it was a big fear of mine. As I was trying to resolve that, I tried to slow time down by the healthy foods. Oh, literally. But yeah, I realized that because I looked around me and I was working on my PhD, and I looked around me and I realized that among people who are the same age, you can never tell. Oh, you can never tell they were the same age. There are people who are in their 30s and they look like they could be collecting Social Security. Oh, there are people who are still collecting who are already collecting Social Security, who could be dating somebody in their 20s or 30s. When you run into a lot of people, and you get to know their ID age and get to see their physical age, you'll realize there's a big disparity. So it made me realize that instead of worrying about time running out, maybe I can add some time to my schedule by keeping my body young. And that was one of the main motivations. And when I was 24 years old, on my ID, that is, for the first time in my life, a girl starts a conversation with me. And it wasn't until last year that I finally dated a teenage girl. It was a decade late, but I did it anyway. And I think keeping my body young has contributed to finally doing something that I've been wanting to do for over a decade. Actually, it's kind of funny because we have been talking about the presidential election. She thinks I was 17 years old, and I had accidentally slipped and said that I had voted for Gary Johnson. And she was like, "How can you vote?" And I told her I have a fake ID, and I proceeded to show her my real ID. And see, I was 29 years old, and there's no way she would believe I was 29 years old. So that really clinched it in that it really was a fake ID. And so I explained to her that I like to travel, and in some places you have to be 25 to drink. And that's why the age was exaggerated that much. And she bought the whole story, which is the craziest part about it. And yeah. And anyway, so healthy eating will prevent you from running out of time for all sorts of things. It's not just dating, it's also career goals. What else can it buy you time for? It buys you time in your life altogether, pretty much, right? It buys you time to save up for retirement. There's a lot of people who are having trouble. Kind of ironic, people worry that when they live too long, that they're going to outlive their money. They forget that if they're healthy, they're extending both their working life and their retirement at the same time. So it buys you time to save up for retirement. It buys you time to recoup mistakes in your life. If you marry the wrong person, if you get involved in the wrong career, if you for some reason end up, hopefully you won't end up sick, but you might get into an accident of some sort and lose time that way. If you can keep your body young, it buys you time to recoup some of those losses. On the flip side of the coin, because you have time to recoup losses, you can pursue some of these things more aggressively. You can marry more aggressively. You could choose your career a little bit more aggressively, knowing that you have extra time on your hands. I know I'm being a little bit abstract here, but you get the general idea. Thanks for watching.